My name is Andreas Werdig, and the title of my final project is A Convolutional Neural Network for Electrocardiogram Classification. The electrocardiogram, or ECG, was invented around 1900 by Wilhelm Endhoven, who received the Nobel Prize in Medicine for it. It detects small potential changes on the skin surface, which is correlated with cardiac function. The ECG is a non-invasive test that can help the cardiologist to diagnose certain heart conditions, such as myocardial infarction or heart attack, cardiomyopathies, repolarization abnormalities, and arrhythmias, such as atrial fibrillation. The ECG is usually read by experienced cardiologists and algorithms. Traditional ECG analysis is based on manual measurements using noticeable points on the ECG curve. The measurements are fluid, which means they can be influenced by the physiological state at the time of the ECG, for example, in the morning or at night. ECGs can be different during winter or during the summer. And the measurements using these points are heart rate dependent. And it is difficult to determine very often manually these conditions because of noise and shape changes. The measurements are subjective and often calculated incorrectly, even by cardiologists or heart rhythm specialists. Computer-derived measurements are known to be prone to errors, and physicians are actually taught that the computer measurements cannot be trusted. Atrial fibrillation is a condition, a very common heart rhythm disorder, that affects 1 to 2% of the population, more than 2.7 million Americans. The risk for atrial fibrillation increases with age, and atrial fibrillation causes significant morbidity and mortality. Patients who have atrial fibrillation experience dizziness, and they have an increased risk of stroke. It can be difficult to detect atrial fibrillation because it can be episodic, and it can be marked by other non-atrial fibrillation rhythms. The goal of the project was to implement a deep learning-based algorithm that can classify single-lead ECG recordings into four classes: normal rhythm, atrial fibrillation, other rhythm, and noise. The data comes from the AliveCor ECG monitoring device, which is held in both hands as shown on the image. It can measure very small potential changes between the left and the right hand. That creates a lead 1 equivalent ECG. The dataset consists of 8,528 individual MATLAB files. These are recordings from customers who purchased one of three ECG devices from AliveCor. The company provided the data for algorithm development to the 2017 PhysioNet Computing and Cardiology Challenge, and they come with manually annotated labels. All the data are available on the PhysioNet website for download. On the right side, we can see some examples of these ECGs, the normal rhythm on top, then the atrial fibrillation rhythm, and an example for other rhythm, and a noisy recording. For data pre-processing, all MATLAB files were loaded into a single HDF5 file. This is the advantage that we can store each ECG with the corresponding metadata, such as sampling rate, gain, and offset, but we can also expand the data and maintain it. We could add data from other sources, for example, from ECG machines that use XML files, the XML format. The data can be accessed easily by the custom batch generator, which I will describe in a few minutes. It then randomizes the data, transforms the instances into spectrograms, which is a mixture of time and frequency dependent features, and then applies data augmentation for training and feeds the data into the model. On the lower right side, you can see the time series and the transform into the time and frequency dependent logarithm spectrogram. And we also apply log transform, which better uses the dynamic range of the spectrogram. For data augmentation, we use zero bursts and random resampling. It turned out that training without data augmentation causes severe overfitting, and augmentation has been shown to reduce overfitting. Zero bursts simulate the loss of contact of a lead and sets the signal to zero randomly. Random resampling just simulates different heart rates by squeezing or stretching the sequences. The model was described in that I'm using here. The model that I'm using here was described by Martin Zielmann in 2017, who participated with his group in the 2017 PhysioNet Challenge. The model has 3.5 million trainable parameters in 72 layers. These are divided into six blocks. Each block contains four convolutional layers. And the receptive field of 3x3 is constant, and the number of filters increases in each convolutional block. It starts with 32 and then increases at the end of each block by 32, so that we end up with 224 filters. Stride is 1 for most layers, except for the last layer in each block, where stride is 2. This causes downsampling of the output, so we end up with 9x1x224 as the output size. We then apply some averaging across the time dimension to end up with 224 data points, which are then fed into a linear classifier. I have used a batch generator. I've modified a batch generator that was originally developed by Sherwin Amidi, who is a student at Stanford. I modified it to work with ECGs. The batch generator can read the time series data from an open HDF5 file and then apply transformations such as extending the time series and padding with zeros, because we need to feed consistent size images to the model. It can do the conversion to spectrograms, apply the log transform, apply image augmentation, data augmentation for training. The data are then fed into Keras model for training and validation. The nice thing about this batch generator is that it enables the use of multiprocessing, which Keras supports. That means it can distribute data preprocessing load efficiently across multiple CPU cores and then deliver batches to the GPU in a very efficient way, so that the training performance is limited by GPU training and not data preprocessing. Now, here are the results without data augmentation. As I mentioned before, because of the large number of parameters, I saw severe overfitting without augmentation. But the model converges initially without problems, but then training loss and accuracy diverges from the validation. So we have severe overfitting, but validation accuracy was around 80%. Now, after data augmentation, we can see that this really helps with the overfitting. There's much less overfitting, but there are still spikes in the validation accuracy, which is likely due to a class imbalance because we only have 10% positive samples, positive meaning atrial fibrillation. This could be fixed by adding a class weight parameter to the loss function, which I've not done here, but that's the next step I would try. So as a summary, I've demonstrated here a convolutional neural network that was published by Martin Ziemann from ETH Zurich in an original paper. The link for the paper is given again on the lower right corner. I've demonstrated pre-processing, the conversion into HDF5 file, extending and zero patterning conversion into spectrograms, and then also I think I've shown a very useful batch generator that can read and pre-process ECG data from an HDF5 file and distribute the load of the pre-processing to multiple CPU cores and then feed the batches into Keras model. The model with 72 layers and 3.5 million trainable parameters converges very well and has an accuracy about 80%. The complete code is provided in two Python script files and one Jupyter notebook. And I'm recording a short and a long video. Thank you very much.